In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Good morning, everyone. Today is Tuesday morning, and it's the 28th week of Ordinary Time already. And last week, we really just heard in the Mass that you're invited to this great wedding feast here, and you're also sent out to invite everyone else, and so that we can prepare our hearts to respond to that invitation and to respond to that call to be missionary disciples. Let us call to mind our sins. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. May your grace, O Lord, we pray, at all times go before us and follow after, and make us always determined to carry out good works, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen. I'm here alone today, so I'll do the readings as well. The first reading is a reading from the letter of Paul to the Galatians. Brothers and sisters, for freedom Christ has set us free, so stand firm, and do not submit again to the yoke of slavery. It is I, Paul, who am telling you that if you have yourself circumcised, Christ will be of no benefit to you. Once again, I declare to every man who has himself circumcised that he is bound to observe the entire law. You are separated from Christ. You who are trying to be justified by the law, you have fallen from grace. For through the Spirit, we, by faith, we await the hope of righteousness. For in Christ Jesus, neither circumcision nor uncircumcision counts for anything, but only faith working through love. The word of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Let your mercy come to me, O Lord. Let your mercy come to me, O Lord, your salvation according to your promise. Let your mercy come to me, O Lord. Take not the word of truth from my mouth, for in your ordinances is my hope. Let your mercy come to me, O Lord. I will keep your law continually, forever and ever. Let your mercy come to me, O Lord, and I will walk at liberty because I seek your precepts. Let your mercy come to me, O Lord, and I will delight in your commands, which I love. Let your mercy come to me, O Lord, and I will lift up my hands to your commands and meditate on your statutes. Let your mercy come to me, O Lord.
Alleluia, alleluia. The word of God is living and effective, able to discern reflections and thoughts of the heart. Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Lord, be in our minds, on our lips, and in our hearts. After Jesus had spoken, a Pharisee invited him to dine at his home. He entered and reclined at table to eat. The Pharisee was amazed to see that he did not observe the prescribed washing before the meal. The Lord said to him, "Oh, you Pharisees, although you cleanse the outside of the cup and the dish, inside you are filled with plunder and evil. You fools! Did not the maker of the outside also make the inside. But as to what is within, give alms, and behold, everything will be clean to you. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. So the readings today are really beautiful. The separation of what it is to be a Jew or a Gentile, Christ has broken down those walls. He has made the two groups one. The prescribed washings before a meal isn't just that good hygiene that you and I practice and washing our hands before we eat. Goodness sakes, it's not that at all. The prescribed washing before the meal was if the Jews had been out in the marketplace, they had to come home and wash off of them that sin or that contamination, really, of being around Gentiles out in the marketplace. And so they were ritually washing to cleanse themselves as true and pure Jews, as opposed to being around us Gentiles. And so Jesus is breaking down those barriers. He came to save Jew and Gentile. He came to make us partakers of God's divine nature, but partakers also in the same promises that were given to Abraham, that were given to all God's people. We are those who share in the promise. And now, instead of putting up walls with ritualistic watchings that separate us from those sinners out there, we're sent to those sinners out there, into the highways and byways, so to speak, to invite everyone now. They can all be part of this wonderful meal. What a beautiful progression of our faith. From God choosing a people to that people now preparing the way for all people to be invited. You are invited, and you are sent to invite everyone else. Today, let's knock down all the walls that divide us, every wall, and let's reconcile ourselves to all our brothers and sisters in the world, especially our brothers and sisters of faith, because that is our faith according to Jesus, and what a wonderful faith we have. The intention of today's Mass is Rodney Wetherill. And now let us offer our prayers to God for our church and our world. Lord, for our church, that we might open our doors to all people, that all may feel the invitation, but also all will feel welcome, we pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. And we pray for our world, that those who have been kept away might be welcomed, might be invited, and might be part of the work God is doing in our world, we pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. We pray for our parish, Holy Redeemer, that she might thrive during this time. We thank you for the blessings you bestowed on us, and we ask you to continue to just care for our Holy Redeemer, we pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For those who are sick or suffering in any way, we pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. And for those who have died, that they might see the face of God this day, we pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. And for Rodney Wetherill, we pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. And a special prayer for a culture of life within our world, but certainly within our country, that we might bring a culture of invitation, but even more, a culture of life. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. And for all those intentions of every heart who watches this Mass, we pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. And we bring all these prayers to you, our loving Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have this bread to offer, which earth has given and human hands have made. It will become for us the bread of life. And by the mystery of this water and wine, may we come to share the divinity of Christ, who humbled himself to share our humanity. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have this wine to offer, fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink. Lord, we ask you to receive us, to be pleased with the sacrifice we offer in humble and contrite hearts. Lord, wash away my iniquity and cleanse me from my sins. And now pray, my sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice of your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. Accept, O Lord, the prayers of your faithful with the sacrificial offerings, that through these acts of devotedness we may pass over to the glory of heaven through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for you laid the foundations of the world and have arranged the changing of times and seasons. You formed us in your own image and set us over the whole world in all its wonder, to be stewards in your name over all you have made, and forever praise you in your mighty works through Christ our Lord. And so, as with all the angels, we praise you, as in joyful celebration, we acclaim, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it. He gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks and praise, he gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Earl, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom and the power and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. Graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. And now let us offer each other the sign of peace. Peace be with you all. Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi, miserere nobis. Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi, miserere nobis. Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi, dona nobis pacem. Which is Christ, is mingling the body and blood of the righteous Christ, being sold to the blessed of heaven. They take love and receive your body, drink your blood. Let's pray together our spiritual communion prayer. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the Blessed Sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire you in my soul. Since I cannot now physically receive you at this moment, come spiritually into my heart. You are already there. I embrace you and unite myself wholly to you. Do not let me ever be separated from you. Amen. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. May the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ be safe for eternal life.
Here's my heart, Lord. Here's my heart, Lord. Here's my heart, Lord. Speak what is true. Here's my heart, Lord. Here's my heart, Lord. Here's my heart, Lord. Speak what is true. 'Cause I am found, I am yours, I am loved, I'm made pure. Can breathe. I am healed. I am free. Here's my heart, Lord. Here's my heart, Lord. Here's my heart, Lord. Speak what is true. 'Cause I am found, I am yours, I am loved, I'm made pure. I have life, I can breathe, I am healed, I am free. 'Cause you are strong, you are sure, you are life, hears my heart, Lord. Hears my heart, Lord. Hears my heart, Lord. Speak what is true. Here's my life, Lord. Here's my life, Lord. Here's my life, Lord. Speak what is true. Speak what is true. Speak.
Let us pray. We entreat your majesty most humbly, O Lord, that as you feed us with the nourishment which comes from the most holy body and blood of your Son, you may make us sharers of his divine nature, who lives and reigns forever and ever. The Lord be with you, and may Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. It was an honor to come into your homes today, into your phones, onto your devices, and to just share with you these wonderful mysteries of our Lord Jesus Christ. And now let us go in the peace of Christ to love and to serve the Lord.